So, I don't know what's up with that. I may if it comes back, I might try seeking a more permanent fix, but for some reason, alt-tabbing helped.
Attention, citizen. The city is on lockdown. Martial law is in effect. Please return to your home and lock your door.
Door? No, not a door. Okay, well, again, Alt-Tab apparently fixed my graphical issues, and I have no idea why. I'm guessing it had to do something that reset friggin' video buffers or something. I'm trying to think about... I'm not a graphics programmer, I've just dealt with graphics a little bit, so I'm trying to think of what logical things would... cause the issue, and then what could potentially logically... Man, the V-Sync... This really needs V-Sync. It has got some serious screen tear, but that is an extremely minor issue compared to the massive, crazy flickering that was going on before, so whatever, I'll take it.
Once I am across, no one gets past. Do you hear me?
Explosions. Yes, I see the holocron. Thanks for pointing it out. Oh, I see. Saber next makes the most sense. Press back to upgrade your force powers. Don't fall off cliffs to not fall off cliffs. Ah, spacebar is not skipping that cutscene. That's okay.
Troopers' lives are cheap. But that Nemoidian architecture is expensive.
Yep. He's a villain, because he doesn't value people's lives.
Martial law is in effect. Please return to your home.
kidding me.
How dare you? I own this city.
Reminder, I'm having to play this game on one monitor, so I cannot see chat. Just looking for some holocrons, you know. You never know what you might find. Doing a pretty good job of just walking into your city. I found a saber crystal. Do I have enough to upgrade anything? No. Okay, what's the next level of this do? Damage power and area of effect are increased. This time is increased up to 5 enemies. Oh, okay. Saber Fury. Put that on secondary. That way I can be rocking a purple saber because purple is the best color. Wait just a little bit longer. It's just taking that thing down. That's fun. Teleporty. Fun.
This city lives for the sport. General Kota is the finest combatant we've had yet. But I see more potential in you.
I have a man down!
Have your missile back.
Realize what opportunity this could be. You could have your fill of wine, women, and blood.
I like the part where they have ball that I can use as an assault weapon.
Your life is a lie.
I can't do this
anymore. The hard way.
Yes, yes I am. Have a nice fall! Hey, I can upgrade a force power. What can I upgrade? I can upgrade... Oh yeah, Saber. Sabers definitely is what I want to upgrade. It's an elevator.
I've seen you fight. Now let's see you run.
Yeah, I'm glad I got the blue backers hanging. He was talking about how expensive the architecture was earlier. So I don't know what's up with him blowing it up intentionally. I feel like they learned a lot of lessons from the previous game in terms of like upgrade system and how easy it is to accomplish certain things like the deflecting blaster shots. Like in the previous game, deflecting blaster shots is just, yeah, you stand there and all the stormtroopers kill themselves with blaster fire. Okay, I think somewhere. Reminder that I'm having to play this on one monitor and cannot see chat. Well, I'm attempting to figure out what to do about this puzzle, in case anybody's trying to help me. Maybe I go this way. How? Hey, that looks promising. The direction the game thinks I should go. One of the things that you'll notice, this is actually something that's kind of consistently the case in sequels that have improved. They make collectibles more distinguishable. Just thinking about this game has made its holocrons much more differentiated, where each type of holocron has its own sort of styling. Now the previous game had the dark holocrons and the Jedi holocrons, or the Sith holocrons, the Jedi holocrons, and the difference there being one of them granted you stuff and the other was a temporary buff. But in this one, you have your experienced holocrons always have that gold look. You've got the crystal holocrons, the health holocrons. Yeah, like they're a lot more identifiable, so you can kind of prioritize better whether or not it's worth trying to get to that collectible to see whether or not it's actually something you really want to pick up. Which is, again, something that happened with Castlevania Lords of Shadow 2 is that they made upgrade stuff in one container and the sort of non-upgrade stuff. The lore stuff in its own sort of separate thing. Like, they did a much tighter job of differentiating collectibles and why you might care. Which I really appreciated. And that's something that they've done here as well. Which way am I going? I'm going this way. No shield for you, you crazy, crazy thing. Not quite high enough. I don't think they quite want you to use that to climb anyway. Those work pretty well though, I found. Okay, I think that was the way I came in, actually, looking at it over there. That looks pretty wrecked. Carboniting the door over while I stand around and watch, because that's what a cutscene is your character standing around and watching for some inexplicable reason. That guy's done. Game? What is wrong with your physics engine? Ha! That's a Jabba the Hutt. Why is there a Jabba the Hutt here? Probably has something to do with gambling. What? I can't help but feel like this character is a reference to something. Oh, it is. That's Guybrush Threepwood. That's from Monkey Island. That's an Easter egg. Hey, Guybrush. Okay, right by Jabba the Hutt. Okay, well, going past the Monkey Island gambling arena. Hey, I found a tram. You know what I'm noticing in this game? TIE Fighters are significantly easier to hit. That's another huge improvement, by the way. Because that was super obnoxious in the previous game. Why does that thing have a Gatling gun? My tram is almost dead. I think my tram just died, guys. Okay. Okay, that's the easy part, that's the TIE Fighters. Now comes the hard part, this attack Gatling gunned thing. How durable is this thing? I've unlocked a new challenge. Minor dream cutscene that I'm having to play this on the monitor for compatibility reasons. I don't know if I'll be able to fix that or not, but it means I cannot see chat. Thank you. play experience points. I don't know why.
The whole might of the Empire is at my disposal. Surrender to me now, or be destroyed.
Wow. That's a freaking insane move. Another hold RT mash A. Okay, something shot at me. Go. Ow, he backhanded me. I mean, as much as robot can backhand anything. I see, we sever its container, it freezes in carbonite, and then explodes. Let's bust this. Okay, what's my upgrade available? Grip or Mind Trick? So grip allows me to lift through two enemies at the same time. I could save up for those, or I could save up a little bit for Saber Throw. I'm going to save up for Saber Throw, I think. You guys are obnoxious over there. Yeah. Okay, that will allow me to upgrade my lightsaber, which causes my saber throw to seek out additional enemies to strike, which sounds exciting. Okay, I'm gonna need to figure out how to get that. There we go, I found a saber crystal. Let's see what that saber crystal is, shall we? Oh, I got double chaos. Okay, cool. Thank you. Haha, excellent. You can go out of that mode to save it. I was hoping that'd be possible. I do think this is a mechanical improvement over the previous game, by the way. Like, overall. Jetpacks are so dangerous, though.
Yes, sir. It's time. Let's do it. Stop him here. Keep him away from the arena at all costs.
Okay, so that needs to be fully charged before you can activate it. X prompts. Hopefully this does not have a bajillion prompts, which is nice. Flying guy.
You were a fool not to bargain with me. Time to die.
I don't need your gun. into that structural. Scarpment? I don't know. Structural thing. Right where he needs to go into this vent. That'd be a goodie. Aha! Goody acquired. I don't know that that was the way that they wanted me to acquire that goody, I should add. But that totally worked, so I'm gonna roll with it. I'm gonna see what saber crystal it is by going to the menu that has the saber crystals. I feel like they changed it on me. Corrosion. Okay, that just does a chance to do corrosive damage to my enemies. Well, no, I think that was... I don't know. Making it very hard to go up this elevator shaft on account of there's an awful lot of holocrons on the way to get. Okay, what do I need for the next upgrade? 22.5k. Okay. I don't know why they're doing them in increments of 1,000. Seems a bit excessive, but hey, big numbers.
Send out the Gorok.
But, my lord, the arena's restraints, they haven't been properly tested.
Open the Gorok gate. Now!
You can sit this one out, General.
By the Force, I knew you were alive.
Well, we'll see how long I stay that way.
Hey, it's a ring. It's a friggin' hell beast. Yeah, I wasn't worried about a rancor either. That chain's going to be relevant. I can see that coming.
Tell me you still use the same comm channel.
I hear ya.
Good timing. I don't know how much more I could take.
No time, General. What the hell is this thing?
I have no idea, but it's big.
That's perceptive for a blind man. Now how do I kill it?
I'm not sure you can.
Thank you. Oh, toxic breath. Smash the button to push the hand back. Then gets fiddled on by his bad breath. Not the most exciting boss fight. This is something that I'd call a Colossus battle. A Colossus battle is when the boss significantly differentiates the player in size, basically. And what ends up happening is you don't have traditional fight mechanics. It tends to be specialized, sort of a puzzle boss. It can work okay, but the downside of it is that it tends to be underwhelming because you're not actually fighting the thing so much as you're surviving it or trying to figure out what you're doing. And it tends to make these large, dangerous looking bosses feel very underwhelming. Like this guy. Well, I'm sitting here waiting for this fight to become the next bit where I can lock him down again. Just a reminder that I, for compatibility reasons, I'm currently having played this game with only one monitor active. And that means I'm unable to see chat. Then mash the B button.
Focus on the chains. Push them into place.
So, as you can see, not the most exhilarating boss fight. Again, because there's no good way of allowing the player to be able to directly confront something with this much of a size difference. So the only way of doing it is to make it this sort of puzzle boss. I'm not a big fan of Colossus battles because I feel that they're kind of... they tend to be rather anticlimactic. And that's just by the very nature of them being pretty impossible to design. Look at the other hand. Patient.
Attack the shackle! Give his hand a push!
Because that's where they have to do things like having, I guess it's Coda, yell at you constantly of what you're supposed to do, because, like, it doesn't follow standard game mechanics.
going to be able to restrain that thing, we need to take it out of commission.
Ha ha ha! Ow!
It's a hanging city. See what you can do about those supports.
Wait. That'll bring the whole structure down.
Got a better idea?
Not so much, no.
Health bars does this thing need, by the way? Legitimate question, because it's clearly become exposed to a third. Okay, I can't really go that way, that's fine. Yeah, do something about his 15,000 health bars. They're spawning a lot of destruction objects. I'm supposed to go over here. Yes. This is a really, really bleh fight, by the way. Again, they tried to make it too big and epic, and as a consequence...
Hurry up!
It's kind of bland, because it's... You don't have a good way of fighting something this size in the normal game mechanics.
Not much time left!
Where are we even falling, by the way, that we can fall this far for this long? Like, this fast for this long, or whatever. Working on it.
Get free! Not much time left!
I would tend to assume so, given we're in free fall. There we go. There goes the Gorog thing. Oh, that makes me think of Pod Racer. Musical cue.
Juno! Where is she?
I don't know.
What?
Well, the rebel fleet is scattered across the Outer Rim. I lost contact with her ship after I was captured. Your alliance is on the run, and I lost an entire squad here. But now that you're back, we can take the fight to the Empire. A major strike is what we really need in order to rally the troops.
I'm not him.
I may be blind, but I'm still connected to the Force.
I'm not Starkiller. I'm a clone. I was grown in a vat to take his place.
Well, is that what Vader told you?
Yes?
I don't believe it. No one can clone Jedi. It's never been done. And I can sense how powerful you are. We can put that power to use.
You have no idea who I am or what I went through on Kamino.
Kamino? If you could provide the Alliance with information on the cloning facilities there, we could launch a full-scale...
No! I just want... Look, I need a place to think this through. To meditate.
To hide?
Until I find her.
We're at war and you want a quiet place to think? The Alliance will be destroyed while you're wandering the forests of Kashyyyk or exploring the caves of Dagobah. You'll let the galaxy die to go... find yourself?
What are you talking about?
Oh. I don't know. Nothing. Go wherever you want. You can take the ship. It's always been yours anyway. Just drop me at the nearest spaceport before you get lost in the stars. Boy.
Hopefully it's just loading something and hasn't hanged. It's possible it's hanged on the cutscene. I am going to pause the stream.